Folic acid is a vitamin which can protect a developing baby from getting a serious problem that can cause difficulties walking.
Spina bifida, anencephaly, these are major birth defects that are either fatal or have serious long-term consequences for the child.
And in contrast to polio, where you only get motor, you only lose motor function, with spina bifida you lose both motor function and sensory function.
We estimate that about 300,000 babies are affected by neural tube defects around the world. Dave and Godfrey Oakley invited me to come to CDC to work on the Vietnam Veterans Agent Orange risk study for birth defects. And we analyzed that data and published it. It was one of the first population-based studies that was done to show that folic acid in a multivitamin could reduce the risk of neural tube defects.
And it was enough to prompt us to figure out whether this was really an idea worth promoting on a public health scale, or whether it was something that was just a fluke.
June the 24th at 5 p.m. in 1991 was probably the most marvelous professional moment of my life, when I got a call from now Sir Nicholas Wall telling me that the randomized controlled trial that he had done to find out if folic acid or a different vitamin would prevent spina bifida, it had turned out to be such a positive study. It prevented 72% of spina bifida and anencephaly, and it was in the gold standard study that we called a randomized controlled trial. And it meant that we could bet the farm that folic acid prevented spina bifida.
So you're doing something that prevents diseases and prevents conditions, with the result of not only saving children's lives, but improving their quality of life.
So the first thing we did was make a recommendation for women who had previously had an affected child with either anencephaly or spina bifida, these two very severe birth defects. And that was one of the easiest policy things I ever did at CDC.
This was a special recommendation because it called for what we now call a high dose of folic acid, a pharmacological dose of folic acid.
If you can prevent something like this, especially on the scale of preventing thousands of these birth defects, then this is a real accomplishment.
How much prevention you get depends on how bad off you are.
The China study was really public health at its best.
At the time we did the China study, people didn't know for certain whether folic acid by itself would prevent neural tube defects.
We sent RJ off to China to do a large community intervention. He wound up showing some really fascinating things.
We were asking folks in the field, the health providers that were in the villages, to take pictures of these babies in a way that we could then use the picture to make a diagnosis.
Among the things that he showed was that how much prevention you get depends upon how high the incidence is when you put the folic acid into the population. And in parts of China, it went down almost 90%.
And the China study was the first and only study that's showed that folic acid by itself, without other vitamins, prevents neural tube defects.
And from that moment on, I knew that all we needed to do to keep tens of thousands of kids each year out of wheelchairs was to get every woman of reproductive age 400 micrograms of folic acid every day. We have lots of success stories about preventing spina bifida with folic acid fortification programs. And the key is you have to make it so that every manufacturer has to do it. So in the U.S., you know, it was prohibited before February of 96, and then it was required 21 months later. And so beginning in January 1, 1998, all enriched grains in the U.S. had to have folic acid in.
So once the folic acid was added to cereal grain products, added to the flour that goes into the bread that we eat and other cereal grain products, then you want to count how many cases of neural tube defects there were.
It has resulted in a substantive reduction in the occurrence of neural tube defects among babies who have been born in the United States.
There are roughly 300,000 cases of anencephaly and spina bifida around the world, and we're preventing someplace around about 15% of that, so someplace on the order of 20,000, 30,000 a year. And it's wonderful. I mean, thousands of kids don't have spina bifida and anencephaly.
To have something so simple as folic acid in fortified foods that can prevent 50 to 70% of these children from having this condition and actually being born healthy, to me, is a success story beyond belief.
Smallpox is gone. Polio is on the way to being gone. I'd like for spina bifida F to be the next one.
And that to me is an exceptional thing to have happened, and I have had the opportunity to be part of that.
Tough not to be an evangelist for this, you know. Thank you.